the way she looked, and I really liked the clothes a lot. The clothes that women wore in Ghana, that was what my favorite thing was about it, was the clothes. And but anyway, she was looked like she was pregnant, and she also had a baby on her back. But I couldn't get over her image. She seemed like an icon. So she inspired a lot of other pieces I did. And another thing, and so this was like an earlier artwork from 2009 and 2010. But I also do these imagined portraits, just women that I imagine. So I'll come over here where I really combine women. These are my imagined portraits. As you can see, like two of them have baskets. And there's also a sunflower theme, because these two have the sunflowers behind them. So instead of carrying something that's very important, like the woman was working at the marketplace and carrying something that had to do with her work and her everyday life. But these are sunflowers. So a lot, some people say it looks like halos. I do have a lot of halos in my work. And then the last two in this particular group are these two with the sunflowers, but they're actually the first two that I did with the sunflowers and daisies. These were the first two. I just, you know, it flows better to go there first. And then I had several that kind of look like the women have wings. I mean, like the woman has wings. So we're going to do question and answer afterwards, but now Natori is going to talk about some of her work.
So here are two pieces that I made. One is titled Market Consequences. I was like inspired to create this piece after learning, doing some research on the slave courts in New Orleans and how like slave owners, they would place into slave pens and like, you know, treat them horribly. And with this piece, I kind of wanted to like convey that, but then also convey the strength and perseverance that the people that they had while like going through those, you know, situations. Piece just because the dots, the colorful dots of the black and yellow, pinks and red are supposed to represent like people coming together and kind of like the, you know, melting pot of our city. We have people of all different races and, you know, colors and ethnicities who come together. So that's what I was talking about. So this piece that I have over here, titled Visible, and it's kind of expressionism piece on just being like a woman of color and, you know, being African American, but never really like visiting Africa yet, and wanting to be able to like experience being in the motherland. So that's what this piece. This one is called Paddling Connections, and this one is about my experience of like family and being close to my grandmother and my mom, but not really knowing, like, you know, like distant cousins or people, or like even my like great grandmother and like ancestors, not really having like a history and like a real connection with them, just because they were like gone before I was even barn. Mm-hmm. And so this is what that piece is about. And it was actually like one of my first like kind of pieces, mixed media pieces, really experimenting with different materials like found wood and also twine, which I really enjoyed working with found objects because I like to create art that's eco-friendly, and also I love to create new, like give new life to things that people have discarded. And this piece is called the Diaspora because just thinking about like being African American, how much like, you know, people have gone through a lot, you know, from like the civil rights movement to even today, and how like and how I know that, like, you know, like being someone of African descent, that like we're on pretty much every, you know, continent there is, and like how like our perseverance and strength it moves from place to place, and that's what that piece is about.
The most recent, oh, but let me not forget about this one right here. This one is one of them. And then there's these five. It has a lot to do with the work I do when I'm teaching. And they're imagined women that were in my head. A lot of times when I'm at school teaching, because I teach at elementary and middle school, and I've taught all different levels of teaching, but at this time, that's what I teach. That's the grade level. And I daydream, and I don't know if that's normal, but like on my off times, you know, I daydream. And I've done it all my life. I've really thought of imaginary people, and I just draw them, and it's in my subconscious, and I don't really know who they are. But some people say they look like me. Some people say they look like relatives of mine. And some people say they look like the same person at different ages. And I think that some people have even said they look like bits and pieces of people, like a little bit like one person, a little bit like another person. And but I think there are definitely people who made an impression on me. So these two at the end, they had the rainbows in the background. This is a woman, this is a man. This is a woman who's a teacher. Now, at one point, we were asked to teach a little bit of math. And that was kind of hard for me, because math is not my favorite subject. So that was on my mind, and I drew a woman with a teacher teaching math. And so, now, I said that anything you would like to say, you know, like later about, ask me questions about it, because it's actually a little hard for me to talk about them because I do them in my head, you know, they're so subconscious, and it's hard to bring it to my everyday thoughts. Okay, thank you.
This piece is entitled Women of Inheritance. And again, it was like inspired by just thinking about like my heritage and, you know, being African American, and just being close to my family. And so I was inspired to take these masks and paint them with acrylic paint. And so this mask, which is primarily painted black, is to represent my ancestors and like represent the, you know, past. And this mask has mainly brown and like white paint, and then like splatters of black paint to represent the present, but also show like the past. And This one represents the future, which has a mixture of the black and brown, which represents like hope and just like strength and confidence in the future. And this piece, this mixed-media piece, it is titled The Women, and it was kind of inspired by story of her trip to Ghana, and like I said, I've never been, but I can just imagine how like powerful and amazing it would be to visit there and just to see Africa from first-hand view. And so it has two figures, one that's kind of in like traditional African colors, and then the other one, which is even more like bright and vibrant colors, but that has like Africa on a mind. So that's what that one is about. And this one is called This Connection, and it was inspired by like my research on the New Orleans slave port and how, you know, like my ancestors were like taken from Africa and like brought to America, and you know, have to like just like imagine, you know, what like my ancestors or what like maybe even just the relatives I may have there that I would never, you know, actually know about because of what happened. And so that's what that. But it's also like a very like hopeful piece as well, which is why I added like brighter colors to things. Like blue. So that's what those are about. So this one, it was actually inspired by a piece that I saw in Noma. It was of this like pretty little woman who wore scarf on her head, and so I learned that in New Orleans there was this law called the, by Governor Miro, called the Tegan Laws, which was a rule that he created where like women of color, they would have to wear a scarf on their head to distinguish themselves from white men, so that like, you know, people in public, you know, would not be confused if of color or not. So that's what this one was inspired by. And these two pieces were inspired by just like childhood and like knowing, being a parent, and like knowing how kids are growing up today, like very like technology focused, and how like I know during my childhood, like we would, you know, go outside more. We would have a, you know, connection to nature, and you know, like how I kind of feel like that's something that's like kind of going out of style. And so that's what these two pieces are about.